I give you a perspective of the region, some issues, and then the potential we see in the region. In perspective, you know, like Brian said, actually there are five different parts in the Caribbean, and the traffic goes through those islands. I mean, we are from the Dutch, we are the main carriers in those seven islands. I think we do 80-90% of the traffic between all the Dutch islands. And you see all the carriers actually they follow the English and the culture traffic here. Caribbean tourism is of course very important. 40% of GDP is tourism, the highest in the world. Tourism is 8% of 8 jobs. And Caribbean is 4 times more dependent on tourism than any other region in the world. So bringing people to the Caribbean is very important. And that is also a job we as airline do for the destination we fly to. You can see here the comparison to the other regions. The Caribbean region, there are 8 EASA airlines. There are also other non-EASA airlines, of course. We do 360,000 annual flights, 70% of the region, and we have 10% of the seats in the region. So I think we do quite a nice job. This is what all the carriers do. You see, we make quite a lot of connections with all of us. So these 8 carriers, they really connect, I think, the Caribbean in very well. I think there is a lot of room of working together, make better connections between us, so there is better connections within the region. And also direct flights would be could increase. If you see growth, the Dutch grows 6%. I think the Dutch grows a lot with Latin America. I mean, that is the focus of us. We have 8 destinations in Latin America, and we're gonna add 6 in the coming year. US office grows, Spanish territory grows. UK arrivals from what I had in the Caribbean went a little bit down. Canada grows, so I think there is a lot of growth still in the Caribbean. And this is interesting. It's 2003. We had in the Caribbean we had 596 routes. I make a orange round because that is the focus of Insular, Latin America, and you can see nothing is happening there to the Caribbean. And now, and basically still nothing is happening in the Caribbean. And on the number of routes went down, but that is probably because a lot of airlines creating hubs. It doesn't mean that there is less traffic. The seats went a little bit up, so it's not much happening. Especially in Latin America, I see the Caribbean is actually doing not much in Latin America. And if you see what happens in Latin America, it's amazing. I mean, the traffic in Latin America, Colombia, in those period grow with 70%, Brazil 100%, Chile 92%. I mean, that is where the growth is when you look in the region where we live. I mean, Curaçao is well situated, and in a nice day we can see the coast of South America. So that is where a lot, I think, also for CTO, that is where a lot of tourism potential is for tourism. Here you see the growth. That is still 2015. You still see that Latin America is still 6% growth in traffic, so there's even in the future we can still do a lot in Latin America. Then we have the effect of taxes, because I think Latin America is of course great, but we also have to look at what we do. We fly a lot between the islands in the Caribbean, and I only took. I mean, we can make this list endless. But I only took 2012, And you can see Curaçao went up 4% in international fee. That is in 1 year. If I look at up in the last 6 years, it will be 80% up. Bonaire went up 24%. The transfer fee international went up 50%. Haiti went up 120%. Venezuela 22%. St. Martin up. Everything is up. I mean, this is Trinidad going to go up 100%. And I mean, we're talking about an industry that, you know, you're doing well when you make 5% of the turnover as a profit. So with these numbers, I think interregional traffic is just not going to happen. You know, if this is the prices that the regional carriers has to pay to move people, it's not going to be a profitable business. And not only taxes increase, in Curaçao the landing fees went up with 100%, ATC navigation went up with 100%. So I mean, this is only 2012. The effect of taxes, and we have a business case here from IATA that did for Chile, and I think it is the same for all the countries, is that you increase travel cost with 1.7%. The arrivals also will go down with 2%. So basically it's nice to make the budget of the government or give the airport more money, but the whole economy is gonna take the damages of this. In the economic effect, if Chile would do the $20 per visitor, they would have $21 million new tax revenues, but the production of Chile would go with 37%. So you make a few happy with 21% and the whole economy suffers almost with double. So this is, I think this is something we really have to work out in a region and think about the whole economy and not thinking about only the budget of the airport or the budget of the government. Think about the whole economy. The whole economy gets better when you get more tourists. I mean, the region is dependent on tourism. St. Lucia, I have here, they didn't increase the $35. They suspended it. And according to CTO statistics, St. Lucia shows the highest growth in the region, 2012-2013. So I want to applaud St. Lucia for doing that. And if they are here, probably we should fly to them. That's going to be my next destination in the Caribbean, because that's our people I want to work with. Just to show another effect of the taxes. Because we do short flights, our fares actually are cheap. A ticket St. Martin Antigua will cost you $350,000, of which $125 is taxes. So 36% of the tickets is taxes. Curaçao, Aruba, 36% of the tickets is taxes. Santo Domingo, San Juan, 45% of the tickets is taxes. I mean, this is an industry where your airline are happy if you make 5% of your turnover profits. With this taxes, I think interregional traffic is not going to make it. You really have to do something on the tax issue if we take interregional traffic serious. And if everybody flew to Martinique and had to make a lot of stops, here's the answer. If you make a lot of stops, the taxes get higher, because for every stop you have to pay more taxes. Tax increases less jobs, and I think unemployment rates are already high enough in the Caribbean. So we really have to rethink the tax issue. Now I go for the regional percentage. I wanted to end a little bit positive. These are the opportunities. The Caribbean is in the midst of United States, Europe, South America, and Mid America. So we as regional carriers can make a nice hub of the Caribbean. I mean, the Europeans came to the Caribbean for that reason. So we can still do it by airplane. The total reach, what we can do as a regional carrier, this is just a regional plane. They are not so expensive. This is where we can go. We can reach with the regional plane from the region. We can reach 390 million people. That's more people than living in the USA. That's more people than living in Europe. So I think we have a huge potential as a regional carrier to bring people to the Caribbean. And I think we have to redefine regional carriers, because the region is as big as our planes can fly. And our planes can fly and have a reach with to 390 million people. And that is, I mean, we are, as Insel Air, we mainly focus on South America. We grow with 30% every year. We were doing 14 destinations in Latin America. So there is huge potential for regional carriers if you just use your reach. Recap. The economic effect of the growth of the airline sector is greater than the daily milking of the aviation sector. I have a flying cow there. Sometimes I feel that I'm a flying cow. We need a tax policy that supports economic growth, and I think as regional carriers we should focus on the potential of the Pan-American region, our full reach that we basically have. Thank you.